What's up, everybody? It's the movie X Kicks, and this is going to be the review of The Old Guard coming up right after. The story of The Old Guard basically centers around Andy's character, who is played by Charlize Theron. She is the leader of this immortal mercenary group. The group, basically, if you don't know what mortals mean, that means they cannot die. Once they are shot, killed, stabbed, they basically heal instantly and come right back to life. In this story, they're basically thrown into a society of basically they're the good guys. They basically fight all the unseen battles that the world doesn't see, far as like kidnappings, rapings, killings. They basically come in and save all the innocent people and kind of prolong life under the radar of not knowing, until a secret group finds out about them and tries to track them down in order to kind of extract some of their DNA for other purposes. And also, while they're on a run from this group, they actually induct a new member who's fitting into the Old Guard, who they must train to fight at the same time of running from this sadistic new group trying to capture them. So that's kind of like a brief summary of The Old Guard. I know it's kind of a lot going on in that summary. But I have to say, this is a really good movie. Like, I love Charlize Theron's character, Andy. I mean, it kind of remind me of the Furiosa from Mad Max Fury Road. Like, to me, that character put me on notice. Like, I mean, I was a huge Charlize Theron fan before Mad Max Fury Road, but after that, I was kind of like, you know, she had a couple of different hits that didn't really resonate with a lot of people, like Atomic Blonde. To me, Atomic Blonde was a really dope movie. It just kind of lagged with the story. I thought the action was great, and I love how her style of action, she really goes in almost kind of like, I hate to say it, like a female John Wick. That's kind of like any time a female comes out that's killing a lot of people, everyone's gonna say a female John Wick. But I'm not gonna say a female John Wick, because in this movie she was immortal, so even John Wick can die. He hasn't died yet, but you guys know what I mean. But I love kind of like I loved Andy's character, or Charlize Theron's character, in this, because she was a badass. And from my understanding from the graphic novel, they actually kind of had to humanize her, because in the graphic novel, she kind of really didn't give a shit about anybody except for her men. And in this movie, she's kind of like a bitch, but she, you know, at the same time, she cares for her men, who her other immortal brothers. And then they add on this new character, they add on this new member, and they take her under her wing, and she kind of becomes the new immortal as well. And you kind of see that kind of almost sisterhood. She tries to go with her, but the other girl, the new girl, is kind of fighting back and forth with not wanting. She's basically in grips of, you know, kind of, she's kind of taking all in of, you know, shit, I'm immortal now. And I mean, like, if I was immortal, like, I would have a hard time processing that, you know, that things can't go back to them, like, you can't go back home. The new member, they got her from the military, and she died in action and then came back, and people start asking questions, and they were going to send her away for a test, and that's when Andy came to save her, to get her back into the group and say, basically, you're immortal and you're part of our group now. And you have a lot of resistance going between the two, and resistance between her new immortal self, and then also resistance towards the group, and this new group just trying to get them. So it's kind of like a lot of mini plots in there, it seems like. But I love the pacing of this movie. I think it's paced very well. You know, from Andy's character to the other kind of merry man, I'm going to call him, because there's three other immortal gentlemen in the group, along with the newest member. They really don't touch on the other characters as much. It's mostly about the new character. But all in all, I have to say, this was a really decent movie. I loved Charlize Theron as this kind of badass mercenary killer. And the thing I loved about it, the thing I really loved about the movie, is that it shows that they're immortal, and it shows kind of the ways how they go from, like, when they first start being immortal, like back in was kind of back in the medieval times to present day. It showed like the different forms of how many battles they had to fight through, how many different wars and different conquerors that they had to fight to get to the point that they're at now, to, you know, 2020. And I love the kind of transition that they kind of had to grow, you know, from being immortal, and the kind of, you know, and the kind of the thing about it, it begs the question of what happened if you were immortal? What if you could never die? Like, you get shot in the head and pop right back up. he's like, damn, would you want that? But be honest with you, I really wouldn't want that, because never dying, just because you never die doesn't mean people around you don't die. You know, that's the one thing that I think a lot of them kind of was hard to, and you know, it's hard to get in grips with, was never dying. You know, everyone around you dies, your mother, your father, your even your kids, like, you know, and you stay the same. And that's I think that's another kind of outer lining story that they didn't add into the movie, was the kind of the kind of the friction between being immortal and, you know, it never ends. Like, they do die eventually, but they'll never know when they'll die. They could be living 500 or 1,000 years, and then 1 year they just finally die. So, you know, with that said, I love how they kind of touched on that aspect of it. I did think it was a very decent movie. It was good action. I love the action. Charlize Theron really kind of always puts down in her action movies, kind of like I said, Atomic Blonde, Mad Max Fury Road. She's had these kind of roles where she kind of elevates her fighting style, her gunplay. So I really love this movie. So with that said, drop me some comments, guys. Let me know, have you seen The Old Guard? What did you think about it? If you loved it, let me know. If you hate it, let me know that too. As always, guys, Mr. Movie X is out. And please, if you like what you saw, give me a subscribe and a like. I'll highly appreciate that. Until next, guys, I'll holler at you later.